In the last episode of our exploration of the true history of Hindustan, we have seen what all brutality was committed in Hindustan by the invader Mohammad Bin Tughlaq. I hope you remember the story of that poor blind man who was dragged from Delhi, and at the end of that brutal action, what remained of that poor blind man was only one leg, which was tied to the cord. I hope you remember that. And we have seen that the successor of this Mohammad bin Tughlaq was Firoz Shah Tughlaq. And let us see what all brutality was committed by this Firoz Shah Tughlaq in Hindustan. This is a picture of Firoz Shah Tughlaq. Here it is written, Firoz Shah Tughlaq ka itihas. What itihas? These people were all highlighted as someone who had donated something precious to Hindustan. But let us see the facts and figures, what were their contributions. This Firoz Shah Tughlaq, he invaded Bengal in 1335. Here we have more information about this Firoz Shah Tughlaq. In 1355, he invaded Bengal. Please pay your maximum attention to this statement, which I am going to read for you. That is, in 1355, this Firoz Shah Tughlaq invaded Bengal, and he offered a reward for every Hindu head, and he paid for the heads of 180,000 Hindus, and he raided all the Hindu villages for slaves. These are historical facts. And he celebrated for 3 days whenever the number of Hindus killed in his territories in one day reached 20,000. He imposed rules for grinding down the Hindus and for depriving them from their wealth and property. He paid for the heads of 180,000 Hindus. If you compare this episode to what all was demonstrated in the film Kashmir Files, I think Kashmir Files is almost nothing. What all the pundits of Kashmir had to suffer was only a minimum part of what all the Hindustan suffered from this terrible person only. And many such barbarians like him had committed several other brutalities in Hindustan. Also, he celebrated when more than 20,000 Hindus were beheaded. Can you imagine? Can you imagine these facts? And another question, why all these facts and truths were concealed from the generations of Hindustan by the central government, which was guided by Jawaharlal Nehru? And this is a question you have to ask. As I have mentioned in the last episode, all the brutality committed by Hitler in Germany is being taught to the children of the school, not in university, only to the children of the schools from the very beginning, at the age of 10, 11 years. Why? Such things should not happen anymore. But why? Why Jawaharlal Nehru did not ask to include these historical facts in the scholastic syllabus? And there was precise intentions. And what were those intentions? You can explore. It will be clear. I just gave you a hint only. Again, this Firoz Shah Tughlaq, this terrible barbarian, he imposed the rules for grinding down the Hindus and for depriving them from their wealth and property. See the reasons for a large majority of citizens of the richest country ever existed in the world having become poor, hungry, and homeless. There is a proverb in English, forgive and forget. But even if you want to apply this proverb to a certain extent, I advise you to modify that proverb, forgive but never forget. Or you can modify it as forgive but remember always. And the next barbarian who came to Hindustan to plunder and kill was Alauddin Khilji, and he was a Mughal, and he invaded Hindustan in 1306. Alauddin Khilji was only one of the several Mughal invaders who came to Hindustan to loot and kill. And in brief, here I have a list of what the Mughals did in Hindustan. They destroyed all the Hindu properties. Hundreds of thousands of Hindus were killed. Tens of thousands of Hindus were taken as slaves. Temples in Hindustan were plundered to loot the whole wealth. And not only, they forced the conversions of Hindus to Islam, and also rapes. Here is the cruelest, the bloodiest, and the most terrible brutality committed by the Mughals. That is the thrilled butchering of children. I've noticed those things. And the last line, that is the thrilled butchering of children. And that was the main enjoyment for these Mughal barbarians. Just think about, these are not silly things to be forgotten forever. These are important things to be taught in the schools so that the new generation of Hindustan will have really boiling blood in their veins. And then only the glorious nation Hindustan can be reconstructed. And fortunately, I repeat, fortunately, we have a central government with eminent personalities who are aware of the real story of Hindustan. But at the same time, it is very important that the citizens also shall be aware of the true story. Then only there will be a correct linkage or a correct communication as well as correct bonding between the government and the citizen. And then only development can be made. And then only Hindustan can regain its original splendor. And please never forget that Hindustan was the richest nation on the surface of this earth ever since 6000 BC. It was the richest country in every field, in science, in technology. And we have also seen that in 4th century BC, there was a scientist who wrote a book of aeronautical engineering, Acharya Bharadwaj, the sage Bharadwaj. And he could write a book on aeronautical engineering in 400 BC. So think about the glory of Hindustan since that period. And it is important that original splendor and glory shall be regained. And in order to achieve this goal, it is important that the past should be remembered. There are many people who say, oh, the past is already gone. Don't think about it. No, it's not like that. The past is the reason for the present. So it is important to learn from the past, to organize the present, to lead to a better future. The next invader of Hindustan was Qutb-ul-Din Aibak. Here we have a representation of the invasion of this terrible barbarian. This Islamic ruler killed and enslaved 100,000 Hindus. He demolished all Hindu temples and erected mosques on their sites. We have the historical evidence of the story of Barbary Masjid. Then he forcefully converted Hindus to Islam and beheaded those who refused to be converted. See how a part of the population of Hindustan became Muslims. Those who resisted or those who opposed to be converted to Islam were beheaded. And then they proclaim to bring us to heaven, where there are 70 huris in each room, which will be opened once you reach there. First, create hell on this earth to pass to the heaven full of whiskey and houris. My dear youngsters, just think about this foolishness which is being continuously narrated. You are young people. You have your brain, fresh mind. Just analyze before you believe this type of extreme stupidity. This is very important. These are all facts which happened in our great nation. So that is the reason why a majority of our people continue to remain in this enslavement, mental enslavement, in this brutal thing which is called the religion. I don't say about one religion, every religion. We will come to the Christianity later. It's not only Islam which was committed this type of barbarism in this world. The Christians were the first to do that. We will come to those realities or those histories in the future episodes. Here we have another barbarian. The name of this barbarian is Nadir Shah, and he lived between 1883 until 1933. And see this picture. This is an original picture. And this is a heap of the skulls of Hindus killed by this person. He raised a mountain of Hindu skulls in Delhi. And the next one is Babar, exactly similar to this Nadir Shah. He raised two heaps of Hindu skulls, one in Kanua, that is about 60 miles west to present Agra, and another in Chanderi, which is in the present Ashok Nagar district of Madhya Pradesh. And here we have another, the so-called Akbar. He assassinated about 30,000 Rajputs in Chittorgarh in Rajasthan. And again, Hindustan had to suffer from other invaders who were named Bahmani sultans. And these barbarians killed nearly 100,000 Hindus every year between AD 1347 and 1527. Not yet finished. In the following episodes, we will see more terrible and more brutal, more cruel facts which happened in Hindustan. I request you to share these videos and episodes to your relatives and friends of the new generation also, so that they also will reflect on these facts. So, thank you very much for your kind attention to my words. See you in the next episode. Jai Hind.